So we're going to define a special kind of operator called a contraction mapping, and we're going to say an operator is a contraction mapping if it has this property. So B is some operator, and it's mapping value functions to value functions. If it's the case that for all value functions, so all value functions f and g, and some multiplicative factor gamma, which is less than 1, if it's the case that the distance between B applied to f and B applied to g has to be smaller than or equal to gamma times the original distance between f and g, then we say that B is a contraction mapping, that it's causing things to get closer together, tighter together. So this notation here is sometimes called the infinity norm, the max norm, and all it's doing is saying this is a function of states and actions. So which is the largest? What's the largest state-action pair in terms of absolute value?
Okay, so that's just saying what's the maximum value that the function q can have.
Or that it currently has. Yeah, that's right. So when we write f minus g max norm, really what's the saying is what's the biggest difference in q values between f and g? And this is corresponding q values.
Mm-hmm.
All right? So f minus g is saying what's the biggest difference between these two q functions at any state action pair? Whatever that largest difference is, we're going to multiply it by something that makes it even smaller. And we're going to say that for it to be a contraction mapping, it has to be the case that if you apply that mapping to f and you apply that mapping to g, the distance between the resulting functions is even closer together than they started.
And that makes it a contraction mapping. Okay.
Yeah, so this is how we're going to define a contraction mapping. And this is going to give us all sorts of nice properties, and it's also going to happen a lot in the kinds of operators we get in reinforcement learning.
So just to be sure that I have this right, since the infinity norm finds the biggest value, and here you've defined the difference between two functions, at least the infinity difference between two functions being wherever their greatest distance is, it's certainly the case that over time, as we apply this operator over and over again, the point where their maximum is, the state action pair where their maximum is, might change every time, right?
Right, that's right. So this max norm is computing for the specific value function that it's given where the biggest value is, the biggest absolute value is. And that could be different on this side of the equation from this side of the equation. There's no reason that it needs to be the same over and over again. And in fact, when we're using B to be kind of like a value iteration operator, it does tend to move around a lot.
Okay. So you would expect it to move around a bit, at least as you're going through value space.
Yeah, exactly. And however, let's not worry about that quite yet. Let's actually do some contraction mapping examples on just scalar values where it's really easy to reason about them.
Okay, yeah, I think that would be cool.